Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem led by Inner Circle musical director Kathy Beaver.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave
a very talented musical director, singer, band leader, the works. Please make sure your cell phones are turned off. A little note, the role of A-Rod will be played by N.J. Burkitt tonight. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the president of the Inner Circle, Philip O'Brien. The president of the Inner Circle, where is Philip O'Brien?
Sorry for making you wait. I was trying to fix a problem over at table 92 over there. It's quite a mess. AIG bought the table a few weeks ago. They used that bailout bonus money to pay for it, and now the feds have seized the table. And Andrew Cuomo is over there arguing that he should sit there. Well, then there's that other matter. Besides being president of the Inner Circle this year, I'm moonlighting as maitre d' for tonight's gala. And as such, I would request that you all just give me a time to go through this by keeping your chatter down a little bit, please. Thank you. So here I am, moonlighting as maitre d' of tonight's gala. Who would have thought last year that this year, instead of reporting the news, many of my colleagues and I would be waiting tables at the Hilton New York. But that's not the only reason we're doing double duty. You see, the Inner Circle is tightening its belt, cutting a little bit here, trimming a little bit there, even making the ultimate sacrifice, working at the Hilton to pay the bills. Take a look.
I mean, I know this is Mark Sweet. Gosh, this is ridiculous.
Well, at least, Hazel, you have a vacuum cleaner with your initials on at HS. What do I have? Rosanna Scott, a lousy name tag. I bet you they gave Chuck Scarborough something good.
Yeah, but wait till his contract is up.
Mm. Oh, this is it. This is the room they've been telling us about.
So this is the wannabe suite?
Yeah, ever since 2001 at the Inner Circle, they let the politicians who want to be mayor stay here.
So Thompson, Green, Wiener, Quinn, they've all stayed here?
Yeah.
It's kind of bare.
Well, what'd you expect for the cheapest room in the hotel? Gracie Mansion?
I'll be able to join you in the Grand Ballroom in just a couple of more calls, but please. Hilton, New York, how may I help you? Reservations? My pleasure. Reservation under what name? Client 9. Let's see. client 9, your usual suite?
It's New York City, you're gonna love it. Just keep in mind, couple places you can't go with a cabbie. Times Square, Union Square, Herald Square, Broadway, Fifth Avenue, Madison Avenue, and Park Avenue. But you know what? If you get really bored, you're stuck in traffic, get Taxi TV, Eyewitness News. So, have a great night.
Okay, thank you.
Man, is this thing heavy. Woo! Now, I've got to get this stuff up to a Mr. Ag, Ag, A-I-G. Oh, maybe it's bailout money. Well, he said he'd make it worth my while. I better hurry.
This concierge thing, tougher than being live at the top of the five. Okay, hold on. Yes, I need Rod Blagojevich for 3 p.m. with Frederick Fekai himself. Stylist to the stars. He's going to love this. Rush Limbaugh, we have the private VIP behind-the-counter tour at every single Duane Reade in New York City, and I'll be getting him his very own swag bag.
If I'd have known all the stories you could find in the coat pockets of these politicians, I'd have started moonlighting here in the coat check room years ago. Check out this one. Pure buckskin. Kirsten Gillibrand told me she shot it herself. And look what I found in the pocket. Guess she can't keep it under her bed anymore. Well, as you can see, Mayor Bloomberg has arrived. He checked his briefcase, but I'm dying to know what I might find if I looked in the mayor's pocket. Let's see. Paul Stewart, this one. Ah, of course, Christine Quinn.
Yasu, Yasu, welcome to my kitchen. Oh, we're gonna have a big banquet tonight in the Grand Ballroom. This is gonna be fantastico. You're gonna love this. I'm gonna make something very, very nice now. I was thinking, instead of the oysters Rockefeller, no, forget about that. I'm gonna do something else. Eggs Patterson. Very, very quick. And it's over. Then I was thinking maybe glazed ham Schumer? Too cheesy. No, I'm not too crazy about that. Then I think maybe, you know, something like sauteed Bloomberger. Too rich. No, no, much too rich. But I come up with something fantastic. The best. Are you ready for this? Rack of Barack. Yes, this is going to be delicious. Rack of Barack. You know what I'm going to do with this? Very easy. Fresh, new tenderloin of pork and lots and lots and lots of gravy. You're gonna love this thing. And for dessert, this is gonna be something you're gonna love. MTA Fair Soufflé. Very easy, you just sit back and watch it rise. You know, you like it? It's gonna be good, isn't it? Yasu, have a nice time. La da da da.
Well, it's been quite a year, as we said, for the news media in particular, as well as a lot of others. Rupert Murdoch won a prestigious battle to own one of the most famous newspapers in the entire world, the Brooklyn
Good
Paper.
Evening.
And you know, it's no longer called news, now it's called content. But there aren't many journalists out there who are feeling it. Content. WNBC has a new 24/7 cable channel called New York Nonstop. We just call it New York Please Stop. WPIX, which last year was called CW11, this year Chapter 11. It's been tough for everyone, but the New York Times has come up with a really great way to shrink the paper for shorter stories. Now they just call it the New York Post. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Now we want you to take a trip into the future and join us, please, for Terms of Endearment.
Good evening, and welcome to Good Day New York content. For you young people, that's what we used to call the news.
It's March 28th, 2030. The big story, mayoral contenders Tatiana Kennedy Schlossberg, Andrew Giuliani, and Mark Green are upset. Mayor Mike Bloomberg wants one more term to finish up the important work he began. back at the turn of the century.
Well, this will be the sixth consecutive election that the mayor has asked for one more term.
We now go live to his press conference at the fourth new Yankee Stadium. The entire New York Press Corps is there.
I'm looking for the entire New York Press Corps.
That's me. I am the entire New York Press Corps. Guess you haven't kept up with the layoffs. That's why they call me New York One.
The 2030 plan ran a little short. We have a ways to go. Or for our Spanish speakers, we have a wayos to goos. I'm running for just one more term to get things finished.
Ain't kidding. The 2nd Avenue Subway, Moynihan Station, they're still not done yet.
And let's not forget this, his latest health initiative from the Bloomberg School of Medicine at Wrangell Community College. No more cream cheese on the bagels.
End transmission.
I refuse to run a schmear campaign. I got it together, didn't I? The city's in love. New York is Bloomberg, Bloomtown. You just can't get enough of me, and I'm loving it.
I'm Tatiana Kennedy Schlossberg.
I'm Andrew Giuliani.
And I'm Mark Green.
One of us could be the next mayor. Maybe not you, Mark. But Bloomberg just won't get out of our way. As my mother, Caroline Kennedy, would say, well, you know...
Yeah, well, as my father, Rudy Giuliani, used to say, shut the freak up. But you're right. If any of us is going to be mayor in 2033, Bloomberg must be stopped.
But he's always one step ahead. When I called for hybrid cabs, he created hybrid cabbies. Half human, half squirrel. They run on nuts.
Guys, we have no choice. I have a very powerful second cousin. 20 years ago, he made California's state budget surplus disappear. And he could do the same thing to Bloomberg.
Right, I know that guy. He's muscular, he has an Austrian accent, and he has the power to go back in history and change things. If he can stop Bloomberg from winning in 2009, one of us could be mayor today.
You're not talking about...
Yes, I am. Arnold Schwarzenegger, the term eliminator.
So long, Mike.
Mike, you've been around for far too long. You got your hooks into the city, you know that's wrong.
You don't know when to quit, it's time for you to split.
Your chance at mayor will crash into the ground.
So long, Mike, time to make room for younger folks.
Voters will learn that you're a hoax.
The next election day, you may hear the voters say,
in City Hall, they don't want you to stick around.
They may remember you, but so long, Mike.
You're ancient history.
So long, Mike.
We're crying foul. So long, Mike.
Throw in the towel.
Did someone call for the term eliminator?
Cousin Arnold, we need you to travel into the past to the year 2009 to stop Michael Bloomberg from winning another term. Someone has to restore democracy to New York City.
No problem. But first I'll make a little detour to the year 2006 and sell my Lehman Brothers stock. In NYC rules a king like mayor. Lay low, lay low, lay hee hoo. He likes to think he's the city savior. Lay low, lay low, loo. I will get rid of that second raider. Lay low, lay low, lay hee hoo. That's why I'm called term eliminator. Lay low, lay low, loo. Low, lay. Well, here I am in the year 2009. Not too much is different, except it doesn't cost $25 to cross the Brooklyn Bridge. On foot? Hey, maybe these girly boys can help me defeat the mayor.
I'm Anthony Weiner.
And I'm Bill Thompson.
Weiner, your buns could use a little work. And you, girly boy Thompson, have you ever hit the gym?
Oh, yes. I crunch the numbers.
One of us is going to beat Michael Bloomberg this year.
Most likely me. You can't make a schnitzel out of a wiener.
Enough. I've come from the future to give you advice.
Bet on the Knicks in 2012?
Don't make me laugh. Okay, boys, it's time to pump you up.
Thought I'd rule
and the controller's not enough. Now in the morning I feel alone. Bloomberg blocked my way to the throne.
I thought I'd roll the dice, follow Schumer's Sunday advice. The New York Times complained as half my staff resigned in vain.
1 minute I held the key.
Next the walls were closed on me. And our mayoral hopes can't stand
up to a billionaire's egotistical plans.
I hear the churches of Harlem giving.
Queens is where most of my votes were living.
Be my mirror, my sword and shield. I could take you in an open field.
For some reason I can't explain,
Gloomy came back and there was never, never an honest vote. We could have ruled the world.
Bloomberg is running for, hold on, another term. So where does that leave me, Christine Quinn? Always the bridesmaid, never the bride. And my political clock is ticking.
Madam Speaker, after all these years of kissing the mayor's butt, what has it gotten you?
I got a garbage transfer station in my district. You know the council, garbage in, garbage out.
And I am so pleased to be supporting the $12 million spruce up of the city's wedding chapel. This could be the first step toward legalizing gay marriage. Right, Lou Fiddler?
Well, we already feature that service in our auxiliary chapel in Diker Heights.
But now, we can compete with the wedding chapels in Vegas. They have Elvis impersonators. We have Bloomberg impersonators.
Well, good evening. Do you, Melissa Mark Viverito, and you, Simcha Felder, solemnly swear to support congestion pricing and wind power and stop eating salt so long as you both live?
We do.
Mazel tov.
Party! Even if Bloomberg screwed me. But hey, no champagne glass for Hiram Montserrat.
Mr. Matt.
Hello, I'm Kevin Sheekey. As Arnold Schwarzenegger's second in command to re-elect Mayor Bloomberg, I'm proud to announce our bold, new, 21st century approach to targeting Latino voters. It's our own telenovela, broadcast on YouTube. Please, watch.
Wunderbar! My plan is working. That video will kill Bloomberg's Latino support. Now I must work my way into his campaign and destroy him from within.
My poll numbers were a little down, so I bought Quinnipiac. And I'm negotiating with Marist. Now, if I could only buy back the respect and the love of the Republican Party, I'm a shoo-in.
Mr. Mayor, maybe I can help. California could use some cash.
Arnold! You're hired. Now, how are we going to juice up this campaign?
People love animals. So I've asked Parks Commissioner Benepe to arrange a terrific photo op with Chuck, the groundhog at the Staten Island Zoo.
Hello, Commissioner. Chucky, baby, how are you? How are you? What's new? What kind of dirt did you pick up at the zoo? What's happening, baby? Ah, yes. You know, Chucky, this is our big chance for more funding. This zoo is such a dog. People are calling it a shit zoo.
Say what?
They're calling it a shit zoo.
A shit zoo.
Shit zoo.
Shit zoo, okay.
So remember, don't bite the hand that feeds you.
What's the deal, Commissioner? If I see my shadow, Bloomberg gets 4 more years. Do you think people still buy that shit zoo?
With that kind of attitude, you're going from woodchuck to ground chuck.
Hello, you are fired. Or at least put on a 4-day work week with reduced pension benefits.
My sabotage plan is working. I'll keep giving him bad advice. Just like all those guys who work for Governor Patterson. And he'll never get reelected.
Sure, blame it on us animals. Like I was telling my friends, the Canada geese. We're nothing but scapegoats.
We helped to create New York's 4th airport on the Hudson, and now everybody wants to pluck us.
They did it, Chip. Chop. The city.
To his island zoo, taking all his food.
He's flipping after me, baby, with the media gangbang, the cheesing with the corncob pipe.
Now you come here on Groundhog Day and grab me by the feet. I bit your glove and drew blood. Now I'm really feeling the heat. But you bit first, you know. Cutting out 300,000 to the bear, to the frogs, the seals, and the apes. There's no grass to feed the cows. So if you
you heard the hog, but I brought three geese along. So from the next on the mic, you'll hear from Sully's birds.
Check it out.
We are a threat to the Jets,
living large
in LaGuardia, and we can fly faster than the eye can see. We're not so foul, man, we're just some geese.
That's what happens when you don't stay in school. Hey, Randy Weingarten. Just got a call from Arnold, the mayor's new campaign manager. He's not thrilled with our latest education initiative.
You mean texting as a second language? I think it's going great, Joel Klein. Just look at these results.
Oh, no respect at all. I give them a BlackBerry, they give me a raspberry.
Well, maybe we are overdoing it. Look at this kid.
You know the problem? Overcrowding.
Precisely. That's why I'm working behind the scenes to eliminate you.
What's happening all over? I'll tell you what's happening all over. Weingarten's gone on another power trip and thinks I'm gonna roll over. That's what's happening all over. I'm tired of the grief she's inflicting.
Hey, Klein, quit whining like you're some pathetic victim.
Victim? When a union shrew drops a hammer on you, you can bet that she works for the UFT.
When you spot Joel Klein bending Zuckerman's ear, bet a six-pack of beer some teacher will get a kick in the rear.
When she says it's kids, do I hear any bits that she's scheming to get some more do-re-mi?
Don't be fooled by her smiling.
More backstabbing than Rikers Island. When Joel Klein crosses swords with the UFT. When the scores are down, she tells Mike I'm a clown and then asks him to sweeten the pension pot.
When Klein tells the press I protect teacher hacks, it's a scurrilous trick, a self-righteous prick just taking his whack.
When a labor pain tries to drive you insane, lousy lawyer, you won't get the best of me.
Evil man,
sweet conniver, you can wager your final fiver that when Klein crosses swords with the UFT, screw you, screw me, when Klein crosses swords with the UFT.
Mr. Mayor, if you want to be respected and reelected, you have to put a little fear in the people.
I'm working on it, Arnold. I'm negotiating with the Patrolmen's Benevolent Association to eliminate Midtown North in exchange for more parking permits. Patty Lynch is breaking my shoes. However, Police Commissioner Kelly tells me that he's got one man who can take the job of an entire police precinct.
Right, Your Honor. After Ed Schuyler chased that mugger on 6th Avenue, I'm convinced he's all we need.
Schuylerman, Schuylerman, friendly neighborhood Schuylerman. He's 6 feet long, mighty tall. He'll hunt them down and catch them all. Look out, look out, Schuylerman.
With Midtown so safe, what better time to ban traffic on Broadway and set up pedestrian malls? Think of all the street people we can bring back.
Oh, Morgenthau. Fresh from your upstate farm, no doubt.
Hold on there. If you're bringing back street people, I, Robert Morgenthau, may have to run for another term to fight the crime that they'll bring with them. What's that?
Oh, just Cyrus Vance and Leslie Crocker Snyder crying.
I mean it, Mr. Mayor. Why, look at the riffraff gathering there now. Melinda Katz, John New, Eric Joya, David Weprin, Mark Green, Norman Siegel, David Yasky, Bill de Blasio.
Well, that's just the latest crop running for public advocate or controller. But wait a minute. You forgot that nice lady sitting over here on the bench. Why don't you come with me? Betsy Gottbaum. Getting ready for her next career.
Actually, as public advocate, sitting on the bench was my last career.
You can't have people like that hanging around Broadway. It's dangerous. And I ought to know. Sing with me, Betsy.
To win another term, you're going to have some big celebrity endorsements.
How about Helen Marshall?
Too big. You need someone that people can relate to, like a nice lady from California who can guarantee you at least 8 votes. May meet the Octomom and her amazing octuplets.
For bringing 8 beautiful kids into this world. At least I'm not buying them like Angelina.
Mommy, who's our daddy?
A famous Staten Island politician. I call him In Vitro Facella.
I prefer to be called In Vino. Hey, anybody seen my car keys? That Octomom, look at that Octomom. I gotta tell you, what kind of a woman? This is some kind of a woman. The other day, she was cleaning up around the house. She found 2 more kids. But I gotta tell you, this Octomom is a strong woman, a fiercely loyal woman, an independent woman. She refuses to tell us who the real father is.
At least I can keep my mouth shut.
So, why did you stop at 8, Octomom? Recession got you down?
Yeah, things are so bad, interest rates have tanked at the sperm bank.
Well, I hear that you're big at Denny's. They got a new breakfast. They named it after you, the Octo Slam. 8 eggs, no sausage. And the guy in the next booth picks up the tab.
In vitro, I'm impressed. Arrested for DUI, an illegitimate kid in D.C., and still, you get Mayor Bloomberg to show up at your fundraiser even after the courts found you guilty.
Well, the mayor appreciates and admires a man of conviction. Besides, he heard we might be getting our own line on the ballot, and he is very eager to head the 8 and 09 ticket. Kids, that's what happens when you drink hard and Rome. Kids, kept the mom unknown to my wife at home. Kids, ruined a perfectly good GOP career. Family values out the window, shameless. And while we're on the subject,
kids, mine will put me into the Hall of Fame. Kids, even though I lost track of half their names, I need a sugar daddy, someone to pay the freight.
Kids, you got your own welfare state.
Those Schmendricks make quite a couple.
New?
Mm-hmm. Kids.
Can I get a test tube for Father's Day? Windex?
Kids.
Ground control to Octomom.
Happy campers, lots of pampers for them, with six for older siblings. Kids, Octomom, you're really on quite a roll. Kids, you could use a lesson in birth control. Just one killed my career. It's I gotta go get a beer.
Arnold, I don't think that the Octomom is going to help me get reelected.
Nonsense. The Hasidim will love her. Now let's get back to the issues. Everyone's worried about the economy, and you're a billionaire. That won't fly. So meet your new finance chairman, Bernie Madoff.
Bernie Madoff? The most evil man on earth? How's he gonna help?
I guarantee, when I'm through with you, Bloomberg, you'll be a millionaire.
That's not a pocket.
As a bonus, I'll let you use my accountant, Hank Morris.
Well, that's something, but what's your background?
My background? Well, it all started in Bible times with my great-great Egyptian grandfather, Ganef Madoff. He was known as King of Denial. He also invented the pyramid scheme. And he collected dues from the slaves. He was the business agent for BC 37.
All that sounds good. But let me see what Ed Schuyler, Patty Harris, and my other deputies think. I don't make a move without them.
Mayor, are you nuts?
Hiring Madoff makes about as much sense as putting a nickel tax on plastic shopping bags.
That's right. Madoff is reprehensible. He ripped off Elie Wiesel and Sandy Koufax, not to mention Mort Zuckerman.
See, I'm not all bad. Let me explain myself. Here's how it really all began.
Old Bernie Madoff did connive,
stole my people's dough,
to rip off members of the tribe,
stole my people's dough.
Low down, Madoff, I want to strangle you. I hate you, you lowlife. You stole my people's dough.
Wiesel, Wilpon, and Spielberg bit,
stole my people's dough.
All their money turned to drag.
Stole my people's dough. Come here, Madoff. I want to strangle you. I hate you, you lowlife. You stole my people's
dough. What's happening here? Making Bernie Madoff my finance chairman? Getting endorsements from the Octomom? And a rodent at the Staten Island Zoo? Arnold, you are trying to sabotage my campaign.
Who told you? How did you know I was? The term eliminator.
It was me, Arnold. Alex Rodriguez. You sold me my first steroid shot, leading to a life of misery, a $275 million contract to boot. So unless you go back to the future and take Madoff, Octomom, and that stupid groundhog back with you, I'm going back to the past and telling the truth for once. And you will never be the governor of California.
Octiliba! All right, A-Rod, I'll go. Auf Wiedersehen, Bloomberg.
Thanks, A-Rod. Even with your bum hip, I could use a guy like you on my team, but I'd probably have to trade Stu Loser and a couple of prospects.
Put me in, Mike. I'm ready to play today. Look at me. I could be.
Check me out in 2037. That's when my last term will be ending. And you'll almost be finished with your Yankee contract.
Thanks, Mayor Bloomberg. And to make sure you win this year, I would like to give your campaign a shot in the...
In the arm?
Mayor? Bendo!
Whoa! His time was up, the end was near, he knew now what he would do then. And then he thought, why should he leave when he wants to have a rich friend? Publishers scold us, said we needed him all our life. Philanthropy was not to be the job of mayors more enticing. Someday when he's 93, he'll get congestion pricing. Ooh.
budget's getting